Hi friends, welcome to EduTab. So welcome to the Fast Track series for NABARD Grade A 2018 brought to you by EduTab. So today is the lecture number 6. So this particular series addresses the important concepts and data points that you need to keep in mind before going to the examination. So this is going to be a very crisp series and you need to revise it multiple times to retain the facts as well. Now, currently we are providing a comprehensive NABARD Grade A 2018 course for a discounted price of ₹5,000. To know more about our courses, you can visit our website www.edutab.co.in. We are also providing you a NABARD Phase 1 plus Phase 2 Current Affairs Punch course, and it can be bought at a discounted price of ₹3,000, wherein we shall cover all the important current affairs which are required for NABARD Grade A 2018 examination. Apart from that, we have also recently launched a new series, which is a test series for NABARD Grade A 2018 Phase 1 plus Phase 2, wherein you shall get nearly 5,000 to 6,000 MCQs to solve. So now to know more about it, you can drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in or you can give us a call at 814-620-7241. Okay friends, so what are we going to have a look at today? So we shall be seeing the important soil horizons. Right? Now we know that when we actually dig down deep into any soil, okay, there are various layers that are visible to us. They're not very easily differentiable, but yes, we can see that there are different colors that exist, and when you see, the texture of it also varies as you go deep down into the soil, right? So when we put these horizons together, okay, they form a soil profile. So basically, when we are referring to various layers of the soil, we are talking about soil profiling. This is also a term which is used, and you need to know another term that is called horizontation. What is it? Kindly have a look at the definition. It says it is a process of differentiation of soil in different horizons along the depth of the soil body. So what is the parameter that is taken here? It is the depth. Okay. Now this differentiation that exists between the different layers of a soil is basically due to various things like the processes of humification, the process of alluviation and illuviation. Okay, and we shall be having a look at what is this alluviation topic and illuviation topic as well. Okay, so now friends, broadly speaking, if you talk about horizons, there are going to be three horizons. Okay, A, B and C. These are the main ones and they are present in all the soil types. Apart from that, we also have an organic horizon that is called O. Okay, and there is one more thing that you need to know, that the A horizon is actually divided into three, okay, A1, A2 and A3, okay, and this A2 is also called as E horizon. So any place you find a mention of E horizon, that means they are referring to A2. So all these three club together, we refer it to as A. Okay, so before we go into each of the layers that we have just mentioned, we need to understand two terms, okay? One is this alluviation, and in the further section, we shall have a look at illuviation. There's a difference. This is E and that is IL, right? So let us just have a look at it one by one. So basically, it is the mobilization and the translocation of certain constituents. And what can be these constituents? It can be certain minerals. Okay, which you can see here. It can be clay, it can be humus, or for that matter, other salts from one point of soil body to other. So basically, we are referring to washing out. So this is a process where all these things that we have mentioned gets washed out basically. Okay, so you're removing these constituents. And how are these constituents removed? It is because of the percolating water. So in general, whenever there are certain layers, if you pour water on the top, okay, the minerals or the humus or the other salts actually get washed out from a particular layer and starts moving downwards. Okay, so this process where these things are getting removed or washed out because of the percolating water is termed as alluviation. So in short, whenever this term comes to your mind, you need to remember it is equal to washing out. Right? And the horizon which is formed by this process of washing out is termed as alluvial horizon. Now this is important point. So which is this horizon in the soil profile that we just had a look at the picture? It is basically A2 or E horizon. Okay, so in examination, if you get in the options E, then this is the correct answer. But if E option is not mentioned, then it is going to be A, because as I told you, E is a part of A. A has three sub layers in it, that is A1, A2 and A3. So when we say E, we are actually talking about A2 layer, sub layer. Okay, so this particular horizon is called the alluvial horizon. Okay, the next process that we're going to have a look at is the alluviation, ILL. Okay, there's a difference. Now, automatically you need to understand that in a particular layer, which is the upper layer, when you see that because of the percolating water, the various matter like maybe clay, maybe humus, right, maybe certain salts, these are getting washed out. So automatically when they're coming to the lower layers, the washing in of the same materials that were washed out take place in the lower layers, right? So now you can have a look at the statement, the process of deposition of soil materials, which is actually removed from the alluvial horizon in the lower layer, okay, is termed as alluviation. So that is washing out, and this particular term is washing in. Okay, and the horizon which is actually formed by this process of washing in is known as alluvial horizon. And which is the alluvial horizon for us? It is going to be the B horizon. So let us just summarize these two processes and form a linking between the two. So this is a horizon, for example, and this is the next one, right? And this is our A and this is our B. Okay, and here we know that there are sub layers. So just think that this particular sub layer, which I'm shading here right now, is going to be E. Okay, so now we are pouring in water, and because of the percolating water that is entering the soil, there are certain clay matters and there is minerals, there are salts, there is organic matter. So all these things actually are getting washed out. Okay, and because of this washing out, this particular horizon that we are referring to is known as alluvial horizon. Okay, and now after washing out, whatever matter is washed out gets collected in this B horizon. So here what is taking place? Washing in is taking place. Okay, and now this particular horizon is known as alluvial. Fine. So the first process of washing out was known as alluviation, formation of alluvial horizon, and the next process where washing in is taking place is known as the alluvial horizon because of the process of alluviation, right? Okay, so now let us have a look at what are the characteristics of each of the horizons that we have just discussed. So first thing, the O, the first one, okay? So it is basically the humus or the organic layer. Now friends, in one of our series of 5 MCQs a day, we had actually discussed in detail what is this humus. Okay, so just shortly, the organic matter that is present in soil basically gets decomposed by the microorganisms that are present in the soil, right? After decomposition, the matter that we get, it is dark in color, is known as humus. And this humus is very essential for a healthy plant growth. Now, mostly this O horizon consists of this humus or the organic matter, and the thickness of this particular layer varies depending upon the soil, right? Next, we move on to layer A. Layer A is also known as topsoil. basically this particular layer constitutes of minerals. Okay, and from where do we get this mineral? Basically from the parent material from which that particular soil is formed. And this parent material is basically the rocks. Now, along with minerals, this particular layer also has the presence of organic matter. Okay, and usually this particular layer, if you can see in the picture also, is usually dark colored. Now, there is one important point that within this A layer that we are talking about, you can see here, there is a particular segment, okay, that is actually going to be light colored. And that segment that is going to be light colored is going to be that of the E horizon. And why is it going to be light colored? Because washing out process is going to take place in this particular sublayer. Right? And because of that, whatever presence of organic matter or the presence of certain minerals or salts, it gets washed out. So there is the presence of light color there. Okay, now moving on, you can see E layer that we were talking about. So leaching takes place here of clay, minerals and organic matter. So we have talked enough about this particular layer. Then coming to B layer, it is also known as subsoil. And as we had seen previously, it is also known as alluvial horizon. Now, it is going to be obviously rich in minerals because after washing out process, whatever minerals are going from there are reaching this particular horizon here. And this is the lower layer, that's why. Okay, so here it's mentioned that minerals that are leached from A or E are actually accumulated here, right? Next, moving on to the C layer. This is basically the parent material, okay? And this is the material from which the soil is actually developed completely, okay? And this material is basically going to be pieces of rocks, okay? And last, okay, this is called R. Whenever you find a letter R which is denoted in the soil profile, then it actually refers to bedrock. Okay, now you can say that this is not soil, okay, but it is located under the C horizon. You can just have a look at the definition also. So it's a mass of rock such as you can say granite, basalt or limestone that forms the parent material for some soils. Okay, so now you can have a look at these two pictures. Both are correct. Okay, the first one that you're seeing on your left is basically not including the E horizon, but you can see in the right, the E horizon is included. And as I told you, it's going to be having a characteristic that is light colored, okay, because of leaching that is taking place here. Now, the last below C horizon, there is, as I told you, R layer, that is a bedrock. Okay, so basically if you say what is bedrock, it is going to be the unweathered parent material. Because it is present at such a depth, obviously the weathering process is not possible in this particular segment. Right? So with this, we have come to the end of the lecture today. So basically, you need to know the various layers that exist in the soil profile. And those two processes are very important, alluviation and eluviation. So these are quite confusing, but very simple. Just revise it one or two times so that it gets registered in your mind. Now, if you found this particular video useful, kindly like, subscribe and share. And the PDF format of this particular video can be accessed from EduTab's Telegram channel, and the link for the channel is placed on your screens. Till then, friends, thank you so much and happy learning.